Hi, welcome back to my channel. Happy Friday. I have my front door open. The morning sun is starting to come through the front window and I still have my cold. I have a cough drop in my mouth, so hopefully I will be able to edit out any coughing I may have. Bruce is feeling better. He is playing with his toy right now. And any noise he makes, I will apologize in advance. Hopefully it won't be too bothersome for you. Today I thought I would do a different video and I would do a mid-year review of the journals and planners that I had intended to use in 2024 and what is or isn't working for me. So it looks like a lot, but in reality it's not. Like for instance, this is my Hobonichi A5 five-year diary, which I am using as my doodle sketchbook to try to document how I am doodling every day of the year. So this I purchased last year. So this is not exactly a new journal, but it's one that obviously is laying right here. So in front of you, I have my Hobonichis. I have the code. This is a book that was given to me, a journal given to me by Alpha Traveler One, who is Kenny. Hi, Kenny. That he purchased from SeaWorld. I've been using this as my food journal review, my ratings book. So my Hobonichis are here. This is my happy planner. That I put in some blank pages as well as my traveler's notebook. But first I want to start off with Bruce's planner. I've been keeping track of his health, his medical issues. So in case you didn't know, Bruce is our English bulldog and he was diagnosed with a rare skin cancer a few weeks ago and he has been in treatment. We've been trying to get his cancer into clinical remission. And I think we've been successful in that, so that is awesome. But he also has a heart problem, which we discovered after we adopted him. And so I keep track of his medical history, his poop, his water intake, his medication, as well as his food, and all his medication in here. So this is my Hobonichi A6. In here I have his weekly supplement. So this is what it looks like, as well as the blank Hobonichi notebook, which I use as his medical diary, his history, so that if any of his doctors have a question about anything, I can flip through his medical history and let them know when things were done or weren't done. So that's what's back here. And this is a snapshot of his week. So this is his week in the weekly supplement, where I keep track of his poop, his water intake, and then down here is part of one of the medication that he needs to take for his cancer treatment. So black is when he drinks in the morning, and anything after 12 o'clock p.m., I mark it in blue. You can tell at a glance when he drinks the most water. And over here is where I keep track of his food and his medication. So this is something that I purchased from Amazon. This is for this week. So Bruce was at a healthy weight when he started his treatment, and during his treatment he lost about 5 to 6 pounds. We needed to get it back up, so I thought it was important to keep track of how much I was giving him every single time, because one of the medications increases his hunger, so I didn't want to overfeed him because he just constantly wanted to eat. I needed to keep his weight at his healthy level. And over here are the list of medications and or vitamins or supplements that he's on. And as I give it, I try to check it off. Like he gets a probiotic for lunch, so that gets a red star. It may be overkill, but the vets do appreciate it. Let's go to my happy planner. This cover was from last year. That's Bruce walking by. I didn't want to buy a new happy planner. I have a lot of happy planner paper that I bought on sale either from Joann's or from the happy planner site, you know, last year or the year before. This is stickers that I created that I just cut out to cover the month. Now in this section, I keep track of our monthly bills. Bills due, amount owed, amount paid, paid. This is something that I generally look at over the weekend. I will go through it and see what bills we need to pay or what bills did get paid. And here I keep track of my husband's business bills as well as our own personal bills, which I do here. And then this one, This is a blank layout for the underneath year. The washi tape are bills that we have, and then every month how much we pay. So once we pay the bill, I will look at it and go, okay, we paid Target $100. So I will look for Target here for the month of June, which is right over here. And then I will write down that we paid $100. And that kind of helps us see how much we're spending at different places every month. And this is something that I created in Google Docs. And then what's back here? Back here, this is my... This was ideally supposed to be my no spend, and if I did buy something, I would have to keep track here. So this is something I have not kept up with. So this one I use for my writing. This one I had meant to use as my food on the go food journal. And then this one I use as my wallet. So in here, I am hoping to self-publish, and so I've been writing, and I've been using the individual notebooks as my information dump of the different books. So I am planning on writing a series, and I have ideas already for book 1, 2, and 3. And so in each one, I have either sketched out the buildings, the town, the different scenes. Here are some words that I needed to look up. Situations that I need to, I guess, research more, I would write in here. And let's see, can I show you anything in here? In here, the very first notebook, I have cut out pictures from magazines. So this is what I sort of imagined one of the houses looks like. And so I have this out if I need to describe it or to kind of get the feel, the atmosphere of my setting. This is what the inside would look like. This is supposed to be my on-the-go food journal. So there's Bruce. That's Angus. She was our first English bulldog, but our second dog. And then there's Kit Kat with Bruce. But let's see, so this is something that I did back in 2023. We went to Jake Rhodes' house. So this is what I had intended to do, but given what's been going on in my life, we have not gone out too much to eat because we live close to Route 66 here in Southern California, and I thought it would be fun to visit the different diners on Route 66, the different restaurants and stuff. We're talking about this. So this is the SeaWorld journal notebook that I use to keep track. This is my food rating of places that we go and eat. So where this one, I will doodle about our food and insert photos. I would do the same thing here. Sometimes I try to rate the place of whether or not we want to go back and eat there. So we tried a place called Dim Sum Express in Monterey Park. So I took a picture of the food that we ate, and then I have our rating system up there. And then what we thought, we also ate at a place in San Gabriel called Dim Sum Box, where I took more pictures of dim sum. So we've been trying to find dim sum places close to us that we can order from. And then here's some that I printed out from my Canon selfie. I put the double-sided tape on the back, which I would put here. So the difference is this one is to go, this one stays at home, and is my rating. So let's put these two together. This is my passport size. This is standard. This is passport. This is my wallet. This has been working out okay. I notice I don't look at it all the time. So this is for the month of July. And then this is for June. And actually, you know what? I do take it back. The only time I do look at it is when we are at the vet or at his oncologist and we need to make appointments. I will try to write down our important appointments in here so that when we need to set up an appointment for Bruce, I can tell whether or not we have anything set up for that day. And then, let's see, this is something that I created where I've been keeping track of birthdays, anniversaries. So this is sort of like my perpetual calendar for the year. Go to my coach. So this is my coach planner notebook. So I purchased, my husband purchased this for me for Christmas last year. And I really wanted it because of Donald. And in here is my commonplace notebook. Some quotes, sayings, I will write it in here. So this is a notebook from Michaels. I think it's one of their artist journals. And let me see if I can show you just the page.
Here's one. So here are some quotes that I found. The stickers are from Happy Planner. You can doodle in here. You can draw. This is what I decided to do. And this is what it looks like for me.
And let me just show you one more.
Did you know a snail can sleep for 3 years? Did not know that. But here are some different quotes or sayings that I like. And this is what my commonplace notebook looks like. And that's what's in here. This I generally keep beside my bed. And I will take pictures of quotes, sayings, whatever, on my cell phone. And then during the night, I will fill it in. Now let's go to, that's my neighbor. Let's go to my reading journal. I have not read much in 2020. My A6 is in here. This is a repurposed A6 planner. And this is from probably 2017, purchased in 2016. So this is a very old one that I did not finish, but I decided to repurpose it. I would read the book, and instead of printing out the photo on my printer, I would draw the cover. I would write down when I started the book, ended the book, whether it's an ebook, a normal book, and then the genre, and then its rating. And then I would write down, you know, quotes that I like, or what I thought of the book. So this is the first book that I read for 2024. This is the one I read. And this is the last book that I read. This one actually got me out of a funk, but I haven't read anything since. So there's that. But I've really enjoyed filling this in. I still have much more to go. So I'm hoping to finish this journal so I can start it. I have so many A6 covers from Hobonichi that if I were to create another reading journal, it would be an A6 size book so that I can use my covers because I have so many. Now this should be familiar to you. This is my A5 cousin. This is my daily dump. And this one I use consistently. So I will put him here. This is my diary, also A6 size. And then I'm curious, for those of you who do keep a diary and you write in it every night, do you write down bad things that happen? You know, things that you just don't really want to remember. Do you write that down? Because I don't. And I've noticed that if I'm having a bad day, you know, Bruce is having a bad experience, I heard something awful about my mom, I won't journal about it because I don't want to remember it. So I do have a lot of blank pages in my daily pages because they're just days that I don't want to remember. And I don't know if that's a good thing. But yeah, I notice I don't write when I have bad days. And I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad. This is my monthly layout. This is my gratitude page. This is where I try to find one good thing that happened in a day. And thankfully, I've been able to keep up with this. But as you will see, when we were having problems with Bruce. This is when he was having his allergies. But at the time, we didn't know what was going on. We didn't know if it was his cancer coming back and it was showing up on his face. But this was a really stressful time and there was just nothing positive for me to write about. And so I left these blank too. So I know that in the month of May, also in my daily pages, they will be blank because I just wasn't feeling it. But then here's April. So I just don't know what to do on the blank days when I'm having bad days. And I've been curious to see how, so if you daily journal and you have bad days, tell me if you, do you write about it? Do you skip and not say anything? What do you do? I don't know what to do other than to leave a blank and to know that when I look back on those back pages, those blank pages, that it was not a good day for me. Now in here, I have my A5 Hun, as well as my traveler's notebook standard size. This is also something that works well for me. So in here, I keep track of my meals, exercise, steps, and weight. This is my daily devotional. And then here's my Hun. And as you've seen in my previous videos, this is something that I do every day. Then the last thing to talk about and to show is my A5 five-year diary in the zip cover. Still soft. I have it in a slip bag, which is sitting over there. Unfortunately, because of what's been happening with Bruce and my mom, I have doodled, drawn, sketched as much as I had hoped for the past couple of months. So this is when I was doing it. So my intent was to doodle every single day something that I find online or whatever puts me on a kick. And I think here I was on a kick with old candies that I used to eat when I was a kid. And it was fun. And then I also kept track of the weather as well as the humidity. But let's jump ahead and you will see that for 2024, at least in February, I was only keeping track of the weather, but I wasn't drawing. And I decided, you know what? I'm not going to stress out about this if it's not filled out. So on days like this, where I did not draw for 2023 or 2024, what I plan to do is when I finally get in here, let's pretend in 2025, I would just go ahead and doodle three things to make up for the past 3 years. And if this journal keeps going past 2027, which is when it's supposed to end, I'm not going to stress out about it. I'm just going to keep going. I want to fill this up on the day that I'm supposed to, in whatever year that I'm in. I'm not going to worry about it, but it has been fun when I was doing it. This is when I was on a bird kick to do. But as you can see, this is from 2023. And then this is where I wasn't. I think this is where I stopped, was in April. Because I don't think I have anything drawn for 2024 just because my pencil boards were there. That's supposed to be an eagle. I think his name is Murphy, who sat on a rock trying to incubate it. And by coincidence, a baby eagle fell out of its nest. And they brought it into the sanctuary where Murphy was able to successfully raise the eaglet, the baby eagle. And they eventually, the baby eagle eventually grew up. They moved him to a different enclosure to learn eagle habits. And they finally released him. This is when I was on a kick in 2023 of drawing old buildings here in LA. I also want to go back. This is a white whale that was seen in Australia back in 2023. But I want to go back and color this. So hopefully one of these days I will get back to doing this. Here's me, Bruce, and Kit Kat in 2023. This one, we had an earthquake. That was Hurricane Hillary coming up the coast. So anyways, that is this. Where did the book covers go? Because I put them away. This is a look of my planners and what worked and didn't work for me in 2024 so far in the past 6 months. I think had Bruce been healthy, I probably would have been better at keeping up with my doodling book. And I also noticed, and I think I've said it in my previous videos when I was showing my cousin as well as my hun, that when these planners are not beside me, they're kind of out of sight, out of mind, which is why this one always gets used, because this is always beside me every single day. And as well as this one I work on during the weekend, so I will pull out my hun and fill it in my cousin. And this one obviously has more photos of Bruce. So there's Bruce if you've never seen him. But it's really chunky because of the photos of ephemera that I put in here. Lots of pictures. I've tried to doodle. And again, I keep saying it in every single video when I show this, that my intent when I first started this was to try to do less photos and more drawing. But with life events, I've actually put in more photos and less drawing because it's just easier to fill in. And then here's some food. This is the Hobonichi paper that I taped in. But that's how to fill it up and to make it chunky, if that is your goal. It's by putting in pictures, clippings, any souvenirs that you may pick up paper-wise that you can tape into your planners. But yeah, so that's a look of my journals. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. If you didn't, give it a thumbs down. Subscribe if you'd like to see after the pin videos generally of my Hobonichi. I hope you guys have a great weekend. I'll see you guys later. Bye.